Understanding how your hair grows is really important in learning why your hair thins and falls out. And also, this knowledge can help you for regrowing your hair or maintain your existing hair by minimizing hair loss. In this episode, I'll explain you in simple terms using an animation showing different phases of hair growth, which can certainly help you combat hair loss or hair thinning and can even help you reverse hair loss. We'll also talk on some anagen hair stimulators and factors. Please watch it till the end. We'll first begin with the parts or the structure of a single hair. Do not worry, we'll not go into full details. Just look at the labels of the diagram and try to understand the structure. It is made up of two parts. First one is the hair root or the hair follicle, this one, and the hair shaft, what we see outside the skin. This is the hair bulb within the hair follicle. This is the blood supply to the base of the follicle. This is very important for you to understand that nutrients reach your hair follicle by no other means except blood supply. Understanding this also bursts all myths about applying special oils and stuff like that that promise hair growth. But some topical applications like minoxidil increases the blood supply and hence increases the supply of nutrients or supplements we take orally as a part of hair treatment. Also remember this tiny projection called dermal papilla, which anchors the hair bulb to the hair follicle and to the blood supply. Before we start with the animated explanation of the hair growth cycle, if you are new to this channel, please click on the subscribe and the bell button next to it to get notified whenever we add another useful episode. Also, please do not forget to like, share and comment with your feedback or queries below the video. Now let's understand the different phases or stages of hair growth cycle. Remember, all your hair are not in the same stage of hair growth cycle at a time. Otherwise, you would intermittently look bald during these hair growth stages. Well, starting from the new growth of hair from the follicle to bulb and shaft and then falling off or shedding off, there are four stages: anagen, catagen, telogen and exogen phases. Let's start with the anagen or growing phase. This growing phase lasts from about 2 years to 6 years. This decides the length of your hair. The longer this phase, the lengthier your hair. Especially in females who have grown very long hair, this phase is longer. This length also varies with different races and your genes also play a very important role in this phase. During this phase, a hair grows about 1 cm or roughly about half an inch every month. Now, why this anagen phase is so important? Well, remember, at any point of time, over 80% of your hair on your head are in anagen phase. And during this phase, the cells in the hair follicle multiply rapidly and keep adding to the hair shaft and your hair grows. And the nutrition to carry out this function comes from the blood supply, as already discussed in the structure of the hair follicle. And this is very important to understand that you must have some great hair growing foods to provide nutrients to these cells through the blood supply. The list of some great foods I have mentioned in one of my videos, you can check that from the end screen link or from my playlist titled Hair Loss. Also, at the end of the video, I shall tell you about anagen stimulators and also reveal you some important info on how to keep your hair in this growing phase or anagen phase so that you look better with stronger and healthier hair. So please watch till the end. Coming to the catagen or the transition phase, the catagen phase is a short transition phase of about 2 weeks when the anagen phase or growing phase comes to an end. It signals the end of the active growth of a hair. In this phase, the hair bulb detaches itself from the dermal papilla and hence from its blood supply and starts to shrink and goes into the next phase, that is the telogen phase or the resting phase. This is simply the resting phase and lasts for about 3 months before it goes into exogen or shedding phase. When the hair is in a resting phase, a new hair bulb starts to begin from the new growth or the anagen phase. Then lastly, the exogen or the shedding phase. It's really important to understand this phase for people who panic losing 50 to 100 hair daily. You see, around 10 to 15% of your hair are in this resting phase. And out of these, they can go into exogen or the shedding phase at any time. So losing about 50 to 100 hair is completely normal. Never panic when you get hair in your hand while shampooing or combing your hair, or if you're finding some 10 to 20 hair on your pillow. That's completely physiological. Now, finally, important info on things that can shorten your anagen or the growing phase. Avoid these factors and implement some good steps to make your hair healthier and stronger. The first factor is the stress. Any form of stress, whether due to illness or even emotional stress, can shorten the anagen phase and more follicles will go into the telogen phase and then shed out. Then secondly, the nutritional deficiencies. Anagen phase needs good supply of nutrients through the blood supply for cells to multiply and contribute to hair growth. This is really important for people who do extensive dieting without proper supplements. Then thirdly, there are some rare cases of unlucky people with unlucky genes who have a short anagen syndrome where they can never grow hair longer for reasons that are unknown. Fourthly, anagen stimulators. Some pharma company products claim to be anagen stimulators that help hair stay in the anagen phase for longer duration of time. Before using any of these over-the-counter products, please consult with your dermatologist. But remember, the most important part of this episode, that is, your hair gets nutrition from blood supply at the base of the hair follicle. And this scientific knowledge of hair growth cycle busts a lot of myths on some nonsense hacks to regrow your hair circulating all over the internet. I hope you got my point, and I'm not here to promote any pharma products. We'll discuss more on these hair growth stimulators or anagen stimulators in another detailed episode. So the bottom line is, a healthy scalp with adequate blood flow will absolutely impact the health and length of your hair. Make sure you watch the hair growth foods episode from this end screen link. Please give me a thumbs up if you like the video. Also share this with your family and friends. Also please comment below with your feedback or queries, and consider subscribing if you're new to this channel. Stay healthy. Okay.